Hi guys, welcome to this video. I'm your logical reasoning tutor Kasturi Sanam. In this video guys, we are going to study about a very important concept which is frequently asked in near about all the competitive exams, and it deals with blood relationships. So guys, there is no such shortcut to solve these problems, but I'm going to explain you the technique that can be used in order to cater to the problems which deal with blood relationship. So let us get started. Please do not ignore this topic. This topic is a bit difficult when we compare the other topics in logical reasoning, but there are going to be questions sure shot which are going to be asked from this topic, blood relationship, in any competitive exam. So please be thorough with this topic. So before we start, if at all you're new to this channel, please do subscribe to our YouTube channel by pressing the bell icon here, and you can also join the Telegram group of ours. So coming back to our blood relationships, I'm going to be covering majorly these topics. So I'm going to talk about family tree. I'm going to spend 10-12 minutes in explaining what exactly is a family tree and how to identify relations in a family with the help of family tree. Then we are going to speak about family tree examples here, and I'm going to solve few questions for you. Then there are three type of questions that are commonly asked in blood relations. One is the family tree kind of questions. Then is the equation based problems. And the last one is where a guy points at a picture and says that this person is my father's uncle's son or something like that. So those kind of questions, who's who, these kind of questions we are going to solve at the end because they are supposedly the most difficult questions. So let's begin with our concept of family tree, and I'm going to spend pretty much time here. So this is very basic, but still I want to prepare you guys for the questions that are coming ahead. So please bear with me. I'm going to spend some 5-10 minutes here on this particular slide and explain you all the relations and what is called who is who. I have taken this image from Google, but this pretty much explains what exactly a family tree looks like. So this is me, and I have a sister and a brother. So whenever I have a sister or a brother, they are of the same generation. When we talk about generations, it means that people who are born near about with us, and they are of near about the same age. So I have a brother and I have a sister, and they are near about of the same age, must be a bit younger or elder to me. So they are of the same generation. So this is my zeroth generation. Then obviously we all have mother and father. So these are my mother and father, and they are the first generation people. Now my mother and father are also going to have their mother and father. So my father has a father and has a mother who is my grandparents. So they are, my father's mother is called as grandmother, and my father's father is called as grandfather. Similarly, my mother is also going to have a mother and a father, and they are also going to be called as grandparents. But my mother's side will be called as maternal, and my father's side will be called as paternal. So whenever I'm speaking about my father's father, I'm going to say that he is my paternal grandfather. And when I speak about my mother's mother, I'm going to say she is my maternal grandmother. So anything that is related with mother, my mother's relatives, they are called as maternal, and my father's side is going to be called as paternal. So we have grandparents who are the second generation. So they are the second generation. And again, of course, they are also going to have parents, and they are going to be the third generation, and so on. So their parents, my grandparents' parents, are going to be called as great grandparents. Now, if at all my grandfather has a brother, then he becomes my grand uncle. Similarly, when my father has a brother, now this guy is my father's brother. So he is my uncle. He is my paternal uncle. Similarly, when my father has a sister, she is going to be my paternal aunt. And her husband is also going to be my uncle. So everybody, whoever is my father's cousins or brothers, they all are uncles for me. And similarly, whoever is my mother's sister or mother's brothers, they are all So similarly, whoever is my father's brother or sister is an aunt for me. She or he is paternal aunt and uncles for me. And whoever is my mother's sisters or mother's brothers, they all are paternal uncle and aunts for me. So they all come in the first generation. Now my grandfather is also going to have a brother, like I said, and that guy is my grand uncle. So we have covered the first generation, we have covered the second generation, we have also covered the third generation. Now let us come below. When I have a son or a daughter, now this is my husband and this is my son and a daughter. Similarly, I am going to have my brothers. My brothers are going to have son and daughter. So he will also have a son or say a daughter. And my brother's daughter is going to be my niece. And my brother's son is going to be my nephew. Similarly, my father's brother, who is my uncle, he is going to have sons and daughters, and they are my cousins. So these here in the family tree, they have shown my aunt's children. So they are also my first cousins, and my uncle's children are also going to be my first cousins. They are called as first cousins. So when I talk about my grand uncle, who is my grandfather's brother, so I have a grand uncle, and his children are going to be cousins of my father. So they're going to be cousins of my father, first cousins of my father. And their children are going to be second cousins of me. So whoever are children of my grandfather's brother or grandfather's sister or of my grand uncle and aunts, they are first cousin of my father. And their children are of the same generation as of me, and they're second cousin. They're called as second cousin. And my immediate cousins are called as first cousins. So my cousins are also going to have children, and they are also going to be called as niece and nephew. So I've covered a generation which is below me also, and I have covered a generation, two, three generations above me. So this entire thing is called as a family tree. And whenever we are dealing with problems which are related with blood relations, we are going to construct a family tree so as to find out who is what. I hope you've got it. Please spend some more time on this slide if you're not clear about this slide, because this is very basic and we are going to use it nearly in each problem to solve problems which are related with blood relations. Now let us see another slide. Now whenever we are going to solve a problem or whenever we are going to construct a family tree, these are the notations that are very important. So whenever we are going to depict a female, then we always use a circle. This is not hard and fast, but these are the notations that I prefer to use, and I think they are pretty easy, so even you can adopt them. So whenever we have a female, then we are going to depict by a oval or by a circle. Whenever we have a male, we are going to depict that by a box. When two people are married, so we have a female who is married to this man, so she is the wife and he is the husband and they are married, we are going to depict by two lines. So whenever you see two lines, you have to realize that okay, they are husband and wife. And when I draw a simple line, a single line, that means that they are either brothers or sisters. So if at all I have this, then this girl is a sister of this guy, and if at all I have this, then these two are brothers of each other. So a single line is going to represent a brother, and double lines are going to represent that those people are married. Then this means that one generation above. This arrow, downward arrow, it means one generation below. So please be familiar with these notations, because in the coming problems, I'm going to deal with these notations only. So let's get started with the problems. Now, these are the common problems that are asked. This is a big case study, and you would be probably asked two, three questions related with this case study. But I'm going to take a case study and I'm going to answer just one question in particular case study, so that we can solve as many case studies as possible. In a family, there are six members, A, B, C, D, E, and F. A and B are married couple, so we have, let us construct the family tree as in when we are reading this question. So there are six members and we have A and B who are married. So these two are married. Of course, I don't know whether A is a female or a male at this point, so I'm just going to leave it like that. Now the second line says A is the male member. So I know he is a male member. So this is how I depict a male member in a box. And of course then B is going to be a female member. So B is in an oval. D is the only son of C who is a brother of A. So we have A's brother who is C. C is the brother of A. So this is C who is a brother of A and D is the only son. So D is the only son of C. So we have constructed four members. We have already allotted them places in the family tree. E is the sister of D. So we have E who is a sister of D. So E comes here. And B is the daughter-in-law of F. So of course, if B is the daughter-in-law. Now, what is a daughter-in-law? I missed this point explaining in the family tree. So I am again going back to the family tree. Now, this person, this is my mother and this is my paternal grandfather. So my paternal grandfather's son is my father and his wife is going to be his daughter-in-law. In Hindi, we call daughter-in-law as Bahu and son-in-law as Damad. So my mother's parents' son-in-law is my father. So whenever there is a married couple, then we have this relations of daughter-in-law and son-in-law. Now, what does it? Now the question says that B is the daughter-in-law of F, which means that F is the father or mother of A. We are not given whether F is a father or F is a mother or what is the gender of F. We are not given that. So we are just leaving F like that. So in this case, B becomes the daughter-in-law of F, whose husband has just died. So we are again given the gender also indirectly by stating that F is a female because her husband has just died. So we have 3 plus 3, 6, 6 members in a family we already have, and this completes the family tree. And now let us go to the question. How is E related to C? So we have to find out how is E related to C. Once you construct this family tree, you get the direct linkage of E and C, and E is the daughter of C. So we have E who is the daughter of C. So you can have a look at this family tree, and this is a direct question. Now let us see another kind of a question. P is a brother of Q and R. So we have Q, we have R, and we have P. So all these are brothers, and we are given that all these are siblings, and we are given that P is a male because he is brother. S is R's mother. So we have S here, one generation above, who these are her children. T is P's father. So we have another guy, T, who is father. So he is of course married with S. Which of the following statements cannot be definitely true? T is Q's father. Now this question is very true. We have just constructed the family tree, and yes, T is Q's father. So yes, this question is obviously true because they all are siblings, and if T is P's father, then T has to be Q's father. S is P's mother. Again, yes, this is definitely true because all of them are siblings and S is one of the siblings' mother. So of course, this is also going to be true. P is S's son. Yes, this is also true. We know the gender of P and he is S's son. And Q is T's son. Now, this may be possible or this may not be possible. We are not given the gender of Q. So, Q can be a female or Q can be a male. Similarly, R can be a female or R can be male. So, Q can be a daughter of T and S or Q can be son. So, this is not definitely true. This may be true, but this cannot be 100% true. So, this may be case. So, the correct answer here is this. Because we are asked which of the following is not definitely true, because the rest of the options are definitely true. Now let us solve another question. So again, here also we have four statements given. Q is the son of P. So we have P here whose son is Q. So we are given that Q is the son, so Q is a male child. P is the sister of R. So we are again given that P is a female and she is the sister of R. But again, we don't know if R is a female or a male. T is the brother of S and S is the daughter of R. So S is the daughter of R. So we are using this statement before the statement and T is the brother of S. So we have P here, who is the brother of S. Who are cousins of Q? So now Q's father is P and Q's mother is P and P's brother is R. So R here is maternal uncle of Q. Now we are looking at with respect to Q here. So R is maternal uncle of Q and anybody who is children of R are the first cousins of Q. So children of R are S and T. So the correct answer is S and T, who are the cousins, who are they are the first cousins of Q. And they are also of the same generation as of Q. Now let us see another problem. Now these are the big questions and they will of course have more weightage. So if you get these kind of lengthy case studies, then be sure that there are 2-3 questions associated with it. So please solve them carefully, because if you get the family tree wrong, you're bound to get all the 3 questions wrong. There is a family of 6 person A, B, C, D, E and F, and their professions are also given. They are lawyers, doctors, teachers, salesmen, engineer, accountant. There are 2 married couple in the family. Now D is one of the married person, I think. D, the salesman, is married to a lady teacher. So D is a salesman and he is married to a teacher. Now it is given that the teacher is a lady. So I have this and D of course is my man here. The doctor is married to lawyer F. So we have a doctor who is married to a lawyer. F, the accountant, is the son of B and the brother of E. C, the lawyer, is the daughter-in-law of A. So the lawyer who is the daughter-in-law, she is a daughter-in-law of this doctor. So we have the doctor who is a male. E is an unmarried engineer and A is the grandmother of F. So we have A and then the doctor is also going to have children and that child is F. So we are given these kind of things. Now let us again read the paragraph, read the case study second time to understand it better. So we have constructed roughly this kind of a family tree, wherein we have 2 married couples. So one is the doctor and married with the lawyer, and another is the salesman who is married with the teacher. So after the first prima facie reading, we get these things that the doctor and the lawyer are married and the second couple is the salesman and teacher. Also, we are given that E is an unmarried engineer. So E is not a guy here. E cannot come here. And then there is another lady who is C here. So we already know this prima facie information. Now let us construct this. Now the teacher, this teacher, he is not, she is not going to be E because E is unmarried. So this is ruled out. So the teacher can either be A or it can be. Can it be B? Can the teacher be B? So here we are given the accountant is the son of B and the brother of E. So yes, the teacher can be B. So the teacher can be A, B or C. She cannot be C because he is a lawyer. Can the teacher be D? No, D is a salesman. Can the teacher be E? No, E is an unmarried engineer. And can the teacher be F? So we are given that A is the grandmother of F. So yes, it is quite possible that F is, this teacher is F. So now let us read this again and we'll eliminate the possibilities. So this says that there are a lawyer, a doctor, teacher, salesman, engineer, and accountant. So there are these six people. There are two married couple in the family. D, the salesman, is married to a lady teacher. Okay, we have already constructed this. The doctor is married to the lawyer F. Now we are given the doctor is married to the lawyer. So, okay, we have that. F, the accountant, is the son of B. So, no, this teacher cannot be F also because he is an accountant and he is a male. He is a son of B. So we have F who is a son of B and brother of E. So we have E who is another person who is a sibling of F here. C, the lawyer, is the daughter-in-law of A and E is an unmarried engineer. A is the grandfather of F. So yes, now we have near about again read it and we have constructed a kind of a family tree here again. Now the teacher can be A and B, both. We have to now identify who is the teacher. Now, is there any other information that is given about B? So let us B or A. So let us see. We are given that F, he is an accountant and we are given that E is an engineer. So here we know that there is a doctor, there is a lawyer, there is an accountant, engineer, teacher, salesman. So we have done everything. We have given professions to everybody. We have identified who is what. So this question asks, how is E related to F? So this question has nothing to do with the salesman and the teacher. This question has nothing to do with the doctor and the lawyer. All it asks is, how is F related to E? And we already have constructed a rough family tree here above, which we wanted to put in here, but we are not able to because the question doesn't state. Gives more information about the teacher, but it gives information about E and F, and we already know that E and F are siblings. F is the brother of E, and it is given in the question that E is an unmarried engineer, and F is accountant who is the son of B and who is the brother of E. So it is already given that he is a brother of E. And then the question asks, how is E related to F? So it is obviously sibling. Because the question itself directly points out that he is a sibling. So probably we need not even construct this whole family tree. We just had to read the question carefully and the question had the answer in itself. So let us move to the next question now. A family consists of six members, P, Q, R, X, Y, and Z. Q is the son of R. So we have Q, who is the son. So he is a male of R. We don't know what R is. But R is not the mother of Q. So it says that Q is the son of R, but R is not the mother. So what is R? R is obviously the father. If he is not the mother, then what is he? He is a father. Now he is married to somebody else, who is the mother of Q. P and R are married couple. So it is already given that P and R are married. So we have the mother of Q who is P. Y is the brother of R. So we have Y who is a male and he is the brother of R. X is the daughter of P. So X is obviously the daughter of R also. So we have X who is the daughter of P and R, and these two are siblings. Z is the brother of P. So we have Z who is the brother of P. How many children does P have? So P has two children who are Q and X. So we have two. Now if at all you look at the point of view of X, then Z is the maternal uncle of X and Y is the paternal uncle of X. Now let us have a look at the last question. Rajan is the brother of Sachin. So we have Rajan here who is the brother of Sachin. Even when we are given names of particular family members, still I avoid using the gender based on the names. Like for example, Sachin obviously is going to be a guy. Nobody is going to name their girl as Sachin. But still I avoid, because the question explicitly does not say. If at all the question asks about gender, then I assume the gender based on the name. But I generally, while drawing a family tree, I avoid putting a gender. And I put it only if it is explicitly mentioned in the problem. Like for example, here it is mentioned that Rajan is the brother of Sachin. Sachin and Manik is the father of Rajan. So we have Manik who is the father of Rajan. So he's going to be married with somebody and these are his kids. Jagat is the brother of Priya and Priya is the daughter of Sachin. So Priya is Sachin's daughter, and we have Jagat who is brother of Priya. So Jagat again is a guy, it's given. Who is the uncle of Jagat? So the uncle of Jagat is Rajan. So this was again a kind of question that can be asked. We have covered the case studies which are related with blood relations. Please go through them and please do practice so that you get a knack of it. I hope we are clear with the notations that I used while solving these kind of case studies. We will meet in the next video wherein we'll be studying about equations. Stay tuned. Thank you.